Livestock farmers know that manure is great for the soil and for crop yields, but not all manure has the same nutrient values. If over-applied or applied in the wrong place or time of year, manure can become a liability. Consistent with 4R principles, rate, timing, and placement do matter. Making rate calculations starts by understanding your manure's nutrient profile, which will vary based on the type of animal, feed, bedding, barn design, and the amount of water in the manure. Good management starts with regular manure sampling to combine with soil tests and cropping plans to determine which fields and at what rates manure should be applied. OMAFRA's AgriSuite software tool can help you or your advisor develop a manure application schedule that works best for your farm fields and matches crop needs over a rotation.
So this job here, we're spreading 5,000 gallons per acre. We've got 100 acres, 500,000 gallons. So it'll take us a little over half a day to spread that once we actually get pumping. We're spreading about 100 acres of wheat stubble. The manure is actually being pumped from another farm, so it's being pumped off farm to this farm location, and it's being pumped via a PVC underground pipeline so that it doesn't matter if there's crops in the way, we can go underneath and we don't disturb anything in sight. We've got two machines that really make our system unique from anybody else. The first machine is this one behind me. It's a booster pump that we can put in line, but it's a special booster pump because this unit is radio controlled. We can drive it around the field and pull manure hose behind us using radio controls. So we can cover larger areas in one setup. It increases our efficiency, but it's also better for the environment. If we can do a larger setup, we're not over applying and doubling up on setups. So we've got our main pump unit set up at the storage tank, and we've got a hose that comes from our pump unit through the buildings to the inlet, to the underground pipeline. And then behind the chicken barn here, we come up out of the ground, we hook another hose on, and we run one hose, and then we put our booster pump, and then our drag hose carries on from there. So it's very easy with this setup now to get the manure off the pig farm, onto this chicken farm, and onto the land that we want it. We are always looking at ways to increase our window of opportunity. And one way that works both for me as a custom applicator and for our customers is we apply on corn after it's been planted, both pre-emergent and post-emergent, up to the V4 stage. We've done some of that, and it's just given us extra time to get the manure out, and also it provides nutrients to the plant at a time when it can really utilize the nutrients that are in the manure. So the custom operators have come into effect quite a bit the last 10 years. Basically, we can capitalize and make the investment in technology to promote a better job. The investment that we make in the equipment is more than most farmers want to make. We use GPS, we use AutoSteer, and we use remote operating controls, all to give us a safe operating system to do our job, whether we're half a mile away from the manure pit or whether we're 2 miles away from the manure pit.
The rate of manure application is adjusted by the speed of the tractor and the valve settings, or the speed of the beaters. Occasionally, you will want to calibrate your spreading pattern. This means weighing manure spread over a set area or using splash pans to collect liquid applied during a test pass. Variable rate manure spreading is already here. New technology exists to measure the nutrients in liquid manure on the go while mapping the application pattern and automatically adjust the application rate according to a prescription.
Juan Peters, I got into manure spreading because I enjoy being social around farmers and I like to communicate with all my fellow farmers. We do dragline services, dairy, pig, any type of manure that's a liquid. We pump right from the barn right to the field. We got booster pumps we can put in line, and we have enough hose to go further than we'd like to say. So the weather is probably the most challenging part in this business. None of us can predict it beforehand, and especially so summer months we're in good shape, fall we're good shape. Spring is when we have a big rush, and once the ground dries up, we want to get the manure out as fast as possible and try and get to as many customers as possible. So the new vertical spreaders spread much wider than the old horizontal spreaders, and we can probably spread more types of manure through these. Dry dairy manure, dry horse manure, sand settled manure, chicken litter, and mushroom waste.
Determining the right rate of application is just the start. If the nitrogen is available for crops, it is also ready to run off or off-gas. If you are applying at warmer temperatures, it's better to apply to a living crop, such as a pasture or a cover crop, to minimize ammonia nitrogen loss. Stabilizers are becoming more popular. As we mentioned in video one, there's now a way to lower the pH of manure during application with the addition of sulfuric acid, which decreases methane loss and increases nitrogen use efficiency. High application speeds, high pressures, and high winds can all lead to gas and odor losses for liquid manure application. Drag lines rather than tankers can dramatically reduce the equipment load on the soil. Low and slow is a winning strategy, along with getting manure bound to the soil within a few hours. Injection is the best, and we're getting faster and tougher equipment. Farmers are also paying attention to field traffic, tire pressures, and soil conditions when applying manure to reduce soil compaction.
I'm Adrian Gutensberger. I operate Gutensberger Farm Services. We're located in Seaforth, Ontario. Our specialty is dry manure spreading. We run a Tebby manure spreader. It's built in Germany. They run a closed canopy type spreading system with a spinner type, which gives us smaller particle size for more even distribution. So generally, the spreading width depends on the type of material. Heavier material will spread anywhere from 40 to 50 feet, and the lighter chicken manures will go down to 25 or 30 to keep a consistent spread pattern. So we run an AgriBrink system on all our spreaders, which allows us to increase and decrease tire pressures. In the field, we run a decreased pressure, and on the road, we increase the pressure.
I am Julia Hodgins, and I work for my dad, Wayne Hodgins, at Hodgins Custom Service. At Hodgins, we spread manure. Behind me is a crawler, which goes in, and I float it around and mix up all the sand, and it brings up, it agitates the bottom, brings up all the sand and the clumps, and boils it. Before the crawlers existed, we normally use pit pumps, which they never really agitated it to the point where it boiled up and brought the sand up and all the solids. So after we've mixed for a bit, then it pumps through the lagoon hoe out to the fields, and then it gets spread.
Maybe someday we will see robots applying manure, but until then, farmers can take advantage of the latest technology by hiring manure contractors with cutting-edge equipment. Manure application on large farms is a surprisingly complex symphony of planning, people, and specialized equipment that starts and stops at the whim of Mother Nature. Manure application is one aspect of farming where you must develop your own systems and strategies that work together to meet a set of objectives, to get the right amount of manure on at the right time for the crop and in the right places that will maximize its value to the next crop while minimizing the losses to water and air.